solving another problem on syntax directed translation. This question came in the GATE exam also. Consider the following translation scheme. We know that in case of syntax directed translation, along with the production rules, we will be having our semantic actions, and we usually write those semantic action within curly braces. Okay, consider the following translation scheme. S produces ER, R produces star E. For this particular production rule, that is R produces star E, we are having one semantic action, that is print star. R produces epsilon. Next one is E produces F plus E. That is having one semantic action, that is print plus. So plus will get printed. And E produces F. It is having no semantic actions mentioned. F produces S. F produces ID. So F produces ID. That is having one semantic action, print ID dot value. Here ID is a token that represents an integer, and ID dot value represents the corresponding integer value. For an input string 2 star 3 plus 4, this particular transition system will print. So 4 options are given. We shall have to solve this problem. Very interesting problem, and such type of syntax directed translation related problems are very common in our exams. So try to get the logic how to solve such problems and solve other problems also later. Okay, now let me start. Here the input string is 2 star 3 plus 4. So 2 star 3 plus 4 I have written. Now let me construct the parse tree in the bottom up approach. That means from the leaf nodes I will be reaching to the starting symbol S. Okay, at first we are applying this one, that is F produces ID, and F produces ID is having the semantic action print ID dot value. So this is my ID, so I am replacing this one with F, so it will print 2. Next, F produces ID will be used here, so it will print 3. Why? Because it is going to print ID dot value. Here ID is this one, so its value means its integer value. Next, I shall go for this, so F will be there and it will print 4. So this much we have done. Okay, now see, these are the production rules. So E produces F, that is one thing, that is the E produces F. So if I replace this one by E, you see E produces F does not have any semantic action. So nothing is going to be printed on the output, or no semantic action is going to take place. Okay, now see, E produces F plus E print plus. So that is the semantic action. So I shall go for E produces F plus E, and that will print this particular plus. That will print this particular plus there. Okay, now we are having F, we are having star, we are having E. So we are having this star E will be R, and it is having the semantic action print star. So star E will be R. Star E will be R, and it is the semantic action is star. And then we are having S produces ER, but it is F. So E produces F is there without any semantic action. So I shall replace F by E. And then S produces ER, no semantic action has been mentioned. So S produces ER will be there. So I have constructed the parse tree successfully. That means it is a valid sentence for the language of this particular grammar or syntax directed translation scheme. And this is my output. So what is that? 2, 3, 4 plus star. So that is my output. Okay, 2, 3, 4 plus star. I think this is mine. So my answer will be going with option number D. 2, 3, 4 plus star. Yes, it is matching with this. So in this way, such problems can be answered. So whenever one sentence will be given to that, go on constructing the parse trees, and depending upon the semantic actions, just go on writing the outputs, and then you'll be solving this one. Plenty of such problems are there. So please try to solve some problems in the same category. Thanks for watching this video.